ingredients to be gathered here, I'll wager.
Shall we see if there's aught to be found while we're here?
What is that, a tower? Nay, a statue.
We ought to take a closer look.
There's no need to make camp here. We've energy enough to press on for a while yet.
It is well to be prepared, but over-preparation will serve us not. Forgotten something, Arisen? You're looking rather lost.
You there! Are you looking to enter the village?
You'd best go elsewhere, friend. What's wrong about this place? There's no business to be had here, that's for sure.
I don't know about you, Master, but word of a curious village does more to spark my interest than deter it.
I take it you're the outsider my lord mentioned. How do you know to expect you? Why not ask him yourself? You'll find him in the manor.
Might you consider lightening your pack, Master?
If you've anything edible. Gladly lessen your burden.
Greetings. I must say I'm impressed by your intuition, sir. You found me out far sooner than most. I trust you are enjoying your sojourn in our fair village. If you have any questions, ask away. I should be glad to aid you. You're curious what I know of you? Quite a bit, I should think. Naturally, I'm not the only one. Our village has its own network of spies and informants, you see, and your title tends to make you stand out among the rumors we collect. You're the second arisen to come to Vermont. And you've allied yourself with Captain Brandt again. In response, she's... Oops. I mustn't say... Don't misunderstand. I'm no ally of the Queen Regent. I merely strive to maintain neutrality. Those who deal in information must ne'er align themselves with a particular power. Such is our village code.
Is there aught else you'd care to ask?
Arthur, you say? I've lived in this village many a year, but I can't say I've heard of someone by that name. My apologies.
Is there aught else you care to ask?
If aught about our humble village seems strange to you, that is easily explained. For 'tis here that thieves are instructed in the skills they require. To begin with, those who wander into the village are evaluated for their potential aptitude. Of course, you are no exception. That you stand here now is proof you were deemed a worthy candidate. Which is to say, you have my approval as the Thiefmeister.
Is there aught else you care to ask?
Aye. Take care, then. You, sir, are worthy of inheriting my ultimate technique. Once mastered, 'twill allow you to fell all foes, both minuscule and mighty. Take it, and do with it what you will.
Well done, Arisen. You have acquired a maester's teaching, an important milestone in mastering any vocation.
It is an honor and a privilege to serve a master so accomplished.
Ah, we shall remain here.
You made it after all. Guess that means I win. Oi, you lot best pay up.
Dear me.
You didn't disappoint, did you? You've done well. Seems only fair I answer any questions weighing on you. Go on. Ask away. Figures you'd want to know about him. We're supposed to be neutral. Ordinarily, I wouldn't say a word about one of our jobs. But I suppose I can tell you, the situation being what is. His real name is Dara. He was one of us, once. But he's been exiled. We had no choice, see? After he went off to play the false Arisen, we're men and women of shadow. Center stage isn't our place to stand. That's why he was cast out. He'll near be part of our village again. That all you wanted to ask? Before all this, Dara was in line to become the next thief, Maester. But he failed. Took a massive injury to the chest during the trial. So the title fell to me. That's when he went off, saying he used the scar in his chest to pose as the Arisen. And what a scheme that turned out to be, eh? Now he gets to sit pretty on the best seat in the kingdom. Still, you'd have a hard time proving that he's not who he says he is. He's a wily one, that Dara. Always was careful not to leave behind a shred of evidence. But we can't have him thinking that he gets to go off and enjoy a peaceful life in the lap of luxury after breaking our code. Methinks he needs something to remind him of the debt he owes us. Here, this should do the trick. Now, as to the Maester's teaching, not sure you'll be able to use it to its fullest potential, but I'll show it to you. That all you wanted to ask? Aye. Till next time, then.
I wasn't worried for a moment. Wherever you go, we pawns will always find you, Arisen.
Do take care not to stray so far next time.
You're here. I've been waiting for you.
Thank you.
knew not what to think when we first arrived here. All those stairs struck...
Fancy a look at my wares? Always a pleasure.
It's rather narrow here. Be on your guard.
We ought to hasten our steps, lest we find ourselves trapped.
I have a knack for gathering items, and am ever on the hunt for new...
Ingredients are plentiful hereabouts.
No harm in picking a few.
That looks promising. Any ideas as to how we might reach it?
Yes, Master. I shall hasten to your aid.
A curative ought to do the trick.
upper hand.
Battle is upon us! Let my magic imbue your weapon with the fury of the elements.
Another statue. Mayhap 'twill yield us aught of use.
Why don't we go take a look? It is broken, and with it our path forward. We'll have to find another route.
Nothing else for it, I suppose.
So soon? Why, we seem to have come through unscathed.
We mustn't allow ourselves to become complacent. Take each trial as it comes.
Come on then.
No sense letting the enemy gain the upper hand. The bit against the worm, as they say.
Hang in there, Master. I am coming to assist.
This has no bearing on our current conversation, but might I say, looking around, it strikes me that we pawns are all men. I wonder if this speaks to the Arisen's reference.
It is surely a coincidence. Don't make such a fuss.
I dare say the Arisen could have defeated this lot without him.
Standing. I'll gather this. It might be of use.
Goblins approach!
We have no means of exploiting our enemy's weakness!
This should be of use. We cannot break it from this side.
Perhaps.
I can't even think straight.
Can't put a price on it.
Stay with me, Arisen. Wait right there.
Well met, sir. How might I be? Service.
Always a pleasure.
Not buying?
That's just as well. Better to be selective than wasteful.
The Arisen is ever prudent in the application of coin.
Come on, have a look.
I'm dead on my feet, but I've much to do yet.
The rules at your leisure.
Greetings. Here we conduct all manner of procedures pertaining to vocations. If there is aught I may assist you with, simply... You say the word. Always a pleasure.
There was a patient, man.
I suppose I'll just have to make the best of this.
I can't.
I cannot bear it.
That's quite enough.
Fancy a look at my wares?
This can't be allowed.
Don't.
A treasure chest. Shall we see if we can't make our way over to it?
I'll slit your bleeding throat.
What am I supposed to do?
Why me?
I'd swear I've not blinked once.
We must rest, though the sun may have fallen, but the day is far from over.
Step lively. The journey by starlight shall make for a nice change of pace.
Feeling rested, I trust?
There
is much we ought to tend to, if we are to strengthen your majesty's claim. Have you divined aught of the false sovereign, your majesty? This appears to be a bill calling for the arrest of a man named Dara. But hold a moment. Does this man's countenance not bear an uncanny resemblance to that of the false sovereign? I see. If your majesty is certain that the two are one and the same, then I am convinced as well. However, but of course. I surmise your majesty intends to post the bill and invite suspicion. A clever plan. The Queen Regent will be forced to deny any connection to our new sovereign, yet will be unable to remove the bill from the public eye. Furthermore, it will serve as an attestation to Dara's existence, which shall remain an undeniable truth till the man resurfaces. And all the while, the doubts lurking in the hearts of the citizenry will continue to deepen. A clever ploy indeed. I shall attend to this matter personally. I have no doubt that this bill will prove its worth in due course. You have my gratitude, Your Majesty.
So, the false sovereign operates at the behest of Queen Reed.
There is much we ought to tend to, if we are to strengthen your majesty's claim as a true arisen. I bear word from Regent Ken Sven, your majesty. He espied the delivery of a suspicious package to a man named Allard. A minister who happens to be one of the Queen Regent's staunchest and most powerful allies in the palace. From the pains he took to remain on scene, 'tis plain that Allard wished this delivery kept away from prying eyes. That alone is reason to suspect a connection to Deezer's schemes. We must get to the bottom of it. The Regent Kin intends to call Allard to his chambers come nightfall. He bids you to use this opportunity to search the minister's chambers and see if there's aught to be learned. What say you, Your Majesty? Are you willing to undertake this task? I shall ensure that the door to the minister's chambers is open between midnight and dawn. Pray, use that time to infiltrate and uncover aught worthy of suspicion.
We have been entrusted with a task. Let us approach it with all due care.
Shall we make for Vernworth Palace?
I see our goal has changed. I would not presume to direct our course, but do let me know if you require a guide. Risen decides our path. We have but to follow.
Those new recruits could bear that. Do you know how long?
You are the Arisen, yes? Follow me! You move along. Should want to pray, be cautious, Your Majesty.
wish the minister would be more careful. He takes the sentinel posted outside his chambers with him everywhere. There are times when no one's standing watch there at all.
Aye, it happened just yesterday, in fact. Put me in the right state when I saw the door unguarded. Still, I suppose there's not much to worry about. It's not as if we let thieves wander around the palace, eh? Oi! Have a little faith in yourself!
Steal yourself, as we shall not.
What business could be so threatened that I must come up and visit?
I would not presume to know, my lord. However, it must be a highly sensitive matter for the regent kin to request a private audience.
Oh, perhaps the boy has finally grown wise to the benefits my favor can bring. He might just be his mother's puppet, but at least he knows what's good for him.
My lord, if someone were to overhear...
Oh, unring your hands, you fool! As if anyone in this palace would dare say a word against me. Now, if Wilhelmina calls, tell her to await me in my chambers. I will return presently.
Surely none more important than this. I speak of the ascension of the sovereign.
Indeed. But that, Your Grace, would be better discussed in the presence of your mother. What are you doing in here? I don't recognize you. Guards?
It seems you've made a discovery regarding the false sovereign.
Certainly arisen. How might I be of aid? My curative magics are at your disposal.
Wait a moment.
We ought to bring word of this to Captain Brand. I believe I can guide you to the person in question. There's a ladder here. We ought to put it to good use. We have arrived.
There is much we ought to tend to. If we are to strengthen Your Majesty's claim, as a true arisen. I know this sigil well. 'Tis the crest of the neighboring country of Batal, a land with which vermin has no official dealings at present. Let me see. It reads, true to our word, we offer you the power of the Godsway. Pray make haste in securing Melv, that all might be made ready ere our plans are set in motion. A meager clue, to be certain. Though, 'tis clear that the Queen Regent conspires with Batal. This does not bode well at all. Though the political situation is stable at present, much blood has been spilled between Vermund and his neighbor in the past. I fear such a partnership would only portend the drawing of more. At any rate, 'twould seem our search has led us to only more questions. Chief among them, what is meant by securing Melv and this Godsway? I will investigate these matters as best I can. In the interim, Your Majesty, should you have time to spare, might you make for Melv? Only once we have gleaned a fragment of the Queen Regent's plot, can we begin to thwart it. And ere it slips my mind, pray, take this. Perchance it will have.
Phasus. Now there's a name to remember. Shall we seek out the young man from the other day? Follow me, Master. I shall guide you to the location. We're in your hands, sir. Much obliged.
Welcome to the... We serve all manner of fine ales here. Come back any time.
Would you mind coming over here? The person we're here to meet is nowhere to be seen. Shall we come back later?
The current hour ill suits our progress. Let us visit an inn or make camp, and set out again later.
Might I be of service?
The goblins, I hope you can reclaim aught from the fiends. 'Twould bring me peace of mind to know. Someone taught them a lesson at least.
Fancy a look at my wares?
Welcome to. And quality's what you need if you want to survive. So before you check the price, just
many thanks. I appreciate the business.
This might contain useful information. Let's have a look then.
What now?
Hoy! Faring well, I hope. Would you care to join me? I'd not say no to a bit of company. I was hoping you'd say that. Do you know, I had a feeling we'd meet here today. Intuition, I suppose. Say, you're not from round here, are you? Are you a traveler? Have you seen many places? How I envy you. I long to learn more of the outside world, but she's always telling me how dangerous it is beyond the palace walls. But that only makes me question her judgment all the more. After all, if the world truly is so perilous, what of the lives of our people? They must be fraught with uncertainty, subject to harsh conditions. It seems unfair that I alone should be shielded from that reality. But listen to me waffling on. Ah, I almost forgot. Here, I brought more of the money I owe you. I should have the remainder ready by our next meeting. My apologies, friend, but I'd best be going. I must thank you for indulging me. I do.
Thank you.